Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
My friends, we are welcomed by the grace and invitation of the Lord to enter into the depths of our minds and hearts as we prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Eucharist. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God and on earth. Peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God in the highest, glory to God, glory to God and on earth, peace to people of Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God. Glory to God and on earth. Peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. For he fashioned all things that they might have being, and the creatures of the world are wholesome, and there is not a destructive drug among them, nor any domain of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable. The image of his own nature he made him. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Sing praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn rejoicing. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as you excel in every respect, in faith, in discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but as a matter of equality, your abundance at the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him, and he stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials, named Jairus, came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent all that she had. Yet she was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. And she said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you asked, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman realized what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid, just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside, except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. And he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha cum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord. Of course, the latest good news is that the danger of the virus is subsiding in our area and the restrictions are being lifted. And as we look back upon this time, we find out that one of the hardest prescriptions that we had to follow was social distancing. It's new to our vocabulary, those little dots along the pathway here to the altar shows us that we were asked to practice social distancing. And therefore, putting up with, of course, with death of loved ones during this time of crisis, there was also the great difficulty in not being able to embrace, to hold hands, to physically touch one another, to show our consolation and affection. People had to look at a distance behind glass at a loved one who was dying, and they couldn't console them by their touch. And yet the power of touch is brought home in the gospel today, where it is mentioned 7 times. And the obvious one was of the woman suffering from the hemorrhages, just saying to herself, if I can just touch his cloak, I will be cured. And of course she was, because of her great faith. The Lord knew that power had gone out from him because someone was able to touch him. It was a touch born of faith, not born of necessity, because there was a crowd. And when you're in a crowd, you're bumping up against each other, jostling against each other, but not the same thing as touching another person with love, compassion, and faith, as we want to do in affirming our relationships and our friendships. We want to have a hearty handshake, we want to have a good embrace. Why? Because we want to physically express what's inside us, that we care, and that we love, and that we want to build a relationship. And that was the essence of this woman's touch. And then, of course, the daughter of the synagogue official is raised because Jesus touched her, took her by the hand, and said, "Arise." And the Greek word "arise" is used for Jesus himself at the resurrection. Jesus rose from the dead. And that touch was a life-giving touch which restored the daughter back to society and back to her family. And the dynamic of the touch is brought about in the first reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death. He fashioned all things that they might have being, is when God touches us. We're alive and stay alive, and we have being and not death. And that's why in that reading from the Book of Wisdom, the verse before it was not read, it's not here, but it said, "Do not court death by erring way of life." In other words, death is not merely physical, but spiritual death by an erring way of life, a life of error and darkness, is courting death, whereas we're called to be immortal. The creatures of the world are wholesome. There is not a destructive drug among them. God formed humans to be imperishable. Definition of the incarnation, the word became flesh, means God touched humanity in a most intimate and complete way by taking on human nature. The infinite gap between God and man was bridged by God reaching out and touching us and becoming one of us, taking on our mortal nature. You couldn't get a touch more inclusive and more substantial than that. God has touched us by assuming humanity. And so, yes, the gospel of life is brought about by the touch. And the levels of healing are manifold. We see that the level of healing is not merely physical, it's also social. For instance, in the case of that woman who had the hemorrhages, you know, she was what they called impure because she had to distance herself. And we know what that means now, social distancing. She couldn't have the normal contact with people. She had to stay away. But now she's restored to society. She's able to go to the temple. She doesn't have to declare herself clean and free to take part in the liturgy. And the touch of God is not only social, it's also economic, as we have in the second reading. The background of the second reading of St. Paul to the Corinthians is a fancy way of talking up the second collection. And we all know this second collection, you're going to be asked to have a specific cause to support. And the cause he has here to support is that there's a famine in Jerusalem. And here he is talking to the Corinthians, who are Gentiles, non-Jews. He's asking them to contribute to alleviate the famine of the Jews in Jerusalem. And that's a call to solidarity. And he's able to make this call to Christians because they have been born again of water and the Spirit, and there is no distinction between, as he said elsewhere, male and female, Jew and Greek, Gentile, non-Gentile. But because of this solidarity, because they are children of the Heavenly Father, they should reach out and touch each other by a gift of charity to alleviate their physical needs of hunger and famine. So you might say that the readings today are very touching. They touch us because we know that the touch of God is that of life, and that the definition of death is merely a passage from one form of love to another. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. We now rise for our profession of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. We come to God with our concerns, confident that our petitions will be heard. For monks and nuns, monasteries and convents, may they grow in holiness and numbers, we pray to the Lord. For those who serve in public office, may they uphold the law faithfully and govern wisely, we pray to the Lord. For summer travelers, may they travel safely and find the Creator in the beauty of creation, we pray to the Lord. That those who suffer with addictions find the sufficient grace and support they need to live their struggles bravely, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this assembly, may they visit the sick and find healing themselves, we pray to the Lord. The special intention of this Mass for the intentions of Nita Burgos and for all of our parishioners, we pray to the Lord. For our sick, especially Anne and Anthony Orlando, those who are listed in our bulletin, may they find true healing and encouragement, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, our deceased parishioners, relatives, benefactors, and friends, we pray to the Lord. And we now pause to include our own intentions. O God of life and the living, you make all that has breath. We offer you our prayers. Hear us and grant what we ask in the name of Christ our Lord.
Our hymn at the presentation of the gifts is number 527, the prayer of St. Francis. That's number 527, the prayer of St. Francis.
Make me a channel of your peace. There is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Please rise as we pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in.
Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, all the clergy and the entire people of God. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. It's through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We now approach our merciful Father using the words that our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And we now exchange a sign of welcome and of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 674, Keep in Mind. Number 674, Keep in Mind.
In mind that Jesus Christ has died for us and is risen from the dead. He is our saving Lord. He is joy for all ages. Keep in mind that Jesus Christ has died for us and is risen from the dead. He is our saving Lord. He is joy for all ages. If we die with the Lord, we shall live with the If we endure with the Lord, we shall reign with the Lord. Keep in mind that Jesus Christ has died for us and is risen from the dead. He is our saving Lord. He is in him all our sorrow, in him all our joy. In him hope of glory, in him all our love. Keep in mind that Jesus Christ has died for us and is risen from the dead. He is our saving Lord. He is joy for all ages. In him our redemption, in him all our grace. In him our salvation, in him all our peace. Keep in mind that Jesus Christ has died for us and is risen from the dead. He is our saving Lord. He is joy. Thank you.
Please rise as we pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, descend upon us and remain with us forever and ever. Our Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Before we sing our final hymn together, I have some sad news for me to report. This is my last weekend with the parish. I've really, really enjoyed serving you all. I've been here almost 9 years, and you're really an extraordinary community, and I'll miss you an awful lot. Thank you. Let's join in the singing of our final hymn together, number 532, Let There Be Peace on Earth. That's number 532, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
You can't imagine how sorrowful. God bless him.
Thank you, Father.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as our Father, we are family. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternal.